Your Observable Framework project probably needs external libraries, or you just want to break it up into smaller modules. You'll need to import them from npm, other remote sources, or local files inside your project. Let me show you how this works. Observable Framework uses the import statement rather than require. You can use require if you need to, but it's deprecated now that ESM and the import statement are the standard and are widely supported. Perhaps the most common type of import is to load modules from npm. In Framework, you do this by using the npm protocol, which looks like this. In addition to the module name, you can also specify the version. You can also pick a particular entry point, like this. If you don't, the default export defined by the module is used. npm imports are downloaded during build time and packaged up with your project. This improves performance, since the packages don't have to be loaded from a different server, and also helps with security. You can also import from your local node modules directory. This way, you can manage your dependencies using npm, yarn, or a similar package manager. To do this, you have to first install the package inside your project, and then use this syntax with other protocol to import the module. There's no way to specify a version in this case, you just manage that in your package manager. Of course, you can also import regular files from within your project. You do this using relative paths, which are resolved to local files. This is transitive, meaning imported files can import further local files or other modules. And these are then watched during preview, so it updates whenever any of them are changed. If you're feeling adventurous, you can also import files from anywhere, simply by specifying a full URL. The downsides to this method are that it's slower, since each remote file has to be fetched at load time, and that you have no control over the file changing or disappearing. Dynamic imports use the import function instead of the import statement. They otherwise work the same, except they don't happen when the page initially loads. That way, modules can be loaded on demand or lazily. That can be a good choice if they're not needed all the time or not immediately when the user first accesses a page. Framework also provides a set of recommended libraries that are available by default and imported implicitly. These can just be used without having to write an import statement. For the full list, see the Framework documentation, but they include file attachment, DuckDB, SQLite, Arcaro, Observable Plot, D3, and more. So these are the ways to import code from npm, local modules, local files, remote sources, and even lazy loading. It's easy to get started with Observable Framework to build great dashboards and data apps with code. And you can draw from the vast amount of existing code out there, so you don't have to reinvent the wheel.